Sample one and try it out because it smells pretty good. weirdest thing I've ever seen, so. I just don't understand high fashion. Like, where would somebody wear that, you know? I mean, and this is very docile compared to some of the other stuff I'm sure that we'll see in here. Oh, I love pretty men. Attracted to very androgynous people. I think androgynous people are incredible because they can look beautiful as a man or a woman, or I mean however you want to identify, but just there's something about androgyny that I am so attracted to. Absolutely stays in place. I was insulted. I got this foundation years ago. It's a staple, and when I went to go like into Sephora to try on or like figure out my shade, the shade that I got is called Bone, and I was like, my skin is hot bone white. That is so insulting. Like, that is so white. Oh my god. Is a cute, I don't know if it's a dress. dresser just up top, but it's cute. I kind of like the looseness of it. It's very relaxed. What is this? Also supposed to be a very good foundation. She's so pretty. Oh my gosh. Yes. Except in a weakness. Her hair is so pretty. Oh my god. Wow. What an ad, though. A very standout ad. It's kind of cute. I could see it. I would probably wear something underneath, maybe. I don't know. Salvatore Ferragamo. I'm not familiar with that designer. Love these boots. But if I unzipped my boots like that, I would absolutely fall down. No doubt about that. Alexander McQueen. I love this dark green. Saint Francis something. They make some really, they're very expensive, but some really good perfumes. Ralph Lauren. I was just thinking of like classy British people. They have some out there stuff, man. Etro, I haven't heard of Etro. Swarovski. I always have a tough time saying that. And I don't know why. Bella Hadid again. What a beautiful scene. In a garden. Oh my goodness. We had other perfume samples. I love perfume samples. The, I don't know how to pronounce that, so Saint Laurent, but I never know how to pronounce the Y-V-E-S part, but Libre. So. pink is a lot, and I'm not a huge pink fan, but if it has, like, you know, a contrasting color to it, like an opposite on the color wheel, then I really like it. Nobody has, but whatever. Giant pumpkin. Those shoes, how impractical are those shoes? Like, what? Where are you gonna walk in those? You're not walking, you're gonna be carried. Okay, that's a vibe. Is that? What are those? actually have a sample of this one that I've used quite a bit. Oh yeah, it's nothing beats the Bright Crystal. It's such a good perfume. Those are all good though. I would wear all of those, honestly. I can always smell like that paper though, like the magazine, which I actually kind of like, I'm not gonna lie. If you know, you know. these expensive fashion websites and like look at their clothes prices, and like I swear it'll be like the most torn up basic pair of jeans for like $2,900 or something, and it honestly makes me laugh because I'm like, that's just insane, like absolutely insane. Look how tiny that bag is. That's a Versace bag. You can't put anything in there besides your chapstick, so have fun with your Burt's Bees and your $3,000 bag. It's probably even more than that. Like, it's cute, but it's not functional. And I like to have things that are cute and also functional. Okay, so that I realize I spent this video just like tearing apart iFashion, and that's probably not very relaxing. But I can't help it. It's just so silly, and I love looking through these, but it's just so funny because I'm always just confused by fashion in general. There's a lot of things I really like that are fashionable, but I don't know. She's beautiful, but some of the stuff that you saw on here, I'm like, I just don't understand, like, when people would be wearing that stuff. So anyways, all that to say, that you enjoyed this magazine video. I will always do more magazine videos. I love them. I think that they are super relaxing. So let me know what other magazines you want to see me flip through.